Hallo daar en welkom. We zitten in een bloedmooi hotel midden in het centrum van Amsterdam. Met uitzicht op de Amsterdamse grachten en een heleboel toeristen die daar langs lopen. Een aantal toeristen, nou echt toeristen zijn het niet, zitten hier ook bij mij in deze kamer. Ik zit hier met Five. Welcome guys. Ze zijn in Nederland voor de promotie van hun nieuwe album Invincible. En wij willen natuurlijk alles van ze weten. En ik ga kijken hoeveel informatie ik daaruit kan peuteren. Once again, very welcome to the show. Glad to have you here. Can you tell me, what happens when you join Five? How did you join Five in the beginning? Do you see an ad somewhere? What happened?
We also, there was adverts placed in various publications, various newspapers. There were adverts on the radio. And some of us heard just through word of mouth from other people. Mm-hmm. We all went to an original audition in different parts of the country because we were all from, well, we're all from different parts of the country and we went to different auditions. Then we all got a recall and there were, that was down to, I think, 14 guys from the few thousand that went for the original auditions. And then they were supposed to choose some more, a smaller group out of those 14 guys. But they liked what they saw with us five, and we got chosen on the day.
All right. So did you know what type of music it would be, what would happen, or was it just a blank?
We knew from the start that it wouldn't be the typical boy band thing, considering they did want like rap. Like in, and on the day when we was auditioning for the second time, there was sort of like Jay done a rap and Abs done a rap. So we knew that if we got into the band, it wouldn't be your typical.
Right. Right. So what do your parents say?
Oh yeah.
You come home and you say, well, Mom, I want to join this guy band, well, this thing, no, and they say?
It was a bit weird really, because we didn't get a chance to say that. We went to the audition, and then like obviously we went back home that first day and said, oh, you know, went for the audition, hopefully blah, blah, blah. There's obviously like, oh, go for it.
They'll be like, they were like, we'll contact you in 7 days.
And then in 7 days time, when we went for the second one, we got that on the day and we was offered a 5-album deal with RCA Records, a 6-album deal with RCA Records. And they told us that within a week or 2 weeks we'd be living together in a house in Surrey and all that.
Because the thing is, they videoed us on the first audition. They got a video of not us together, but individually.
Right.
And pretty much as soon as we got there in the morning, we had to do something on our own. And then literally straight away, it was, you know, this five was us five. And there was like a group of another five and a group of another five. And we had to sort of just be on stage together for literally 10 minutes. And then it was like, right, the others couldn't go. We were pulled in. It was like, there you go, 6-album deal, RCA Records.
And then they put you in a home somewhere. You didn't know each other.
Yeah.
You had to just quit your jobs, quit school.
I was at school at the time. I had to quit school and come down and live with these four nutters.
That must be terrible.
Nutters.
Wasn't it weird? I mean, you just get stuck in one house with all these people you don't
at
know.
At first it was weird, but I mean, basically, we got used to it straight away and we're not going to lie and say we've never had arguments, we've never had like near fights or whatever, but we do get on really well and we did quite, you know, quite fast, so it was good, it was a laugh, we had a good time.
So then during the day you rehearsed, sang, wrote, what did you do?
Yeah, we shot lights, which is dance.
Yeah. Absolutely annihilated and wrecked the house, is what, because at first when we first moved into the house, that was mainly to get us to get to know each other and so to see if we liked each other, because there wasn't actually that much work to do at that time when we first moved in. So we used to do a few photo shoots and then we'd have just too much time on our hands really, so we just used to get bored in the house and wreck the house and
go down the offie.
Yeah, go out and buy and we just used to sit in drinking all the time. And
you got your bad name before anything. Yeah.
I used to make lads of, I made pizza for the lads a couple of times, didn't
I? I made curry.
And I remember Rich and Jay went for a really healthy packed, and they used to go down to the supermarket and they used to buy sweet corn and tuna and
yellow peppers.
Yeah, yellow peppers, mix them all together.
Spring onion.
With a baguette. Yeah. You know, so.
In Charles.
So you have fun, it was alright.
Sure. It was good.
Yeah. And then you make your first single, you make your very first video ever, probably.
Mm-hmm. The first song we recorded was our first single.
Right. And which was a day after we moved into the house. We moved into the house in on the
10th of May.
No, of May.
May.
And then on the 11th of May 1997, we recorded the first single, so.
Oh, really? That fast?
Yeah.
Get up.
All right, so then you've lived in the house, and then you've gotten used to each other, and then you make your first single, you make your first video, you win your first award, you get your first fans. Yeah. How does that feel?
Weird, strange.
Yeah.
Good. Bad. Nice.
Was it scary?
For me personally, I'm only just... Not that I'll ever get used to it, but I'm only just sort of coming to terms with it,
yeah.
If you know what I mean.
After 2.5 years.
After 2.5 years, because, you know, you're working so much that you haven't got time to think, this is where I am. You're always thinking ahead and thinking, right, this is coming up, so we've got it, you know, so...
Got to do this day, got to do that.
You know, yeah. So you're always thinking ahead rather than what you've already done.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. So do you remember your first major thing where you thought, wow, this is fame, this
it
is...
It was here.
Pepsi
really?
Pop. It was here. We done a big show. We done it was in 97, obviously. We done a Pepsi Pop 97. Mm-hmm. And obviously, since then, we've headlined it, I think, 3 times.
Twice.
Oh, and the first time, we was on. And slight things went wrong on the show, but, you know, it'll always remember it as, like, one of the first big shows we've ever done, so.
Yeah. Amazing. You remember TMF Awards?
Yeah.
Major thing.
We won 3 awards.
So, when did you get your first fans? What crazy things did people do?
Oh, all sorts of crazy things.
It's so weird.
Like, what a tired one.
I remember.
That.
Yeah, that was.
I remember the first fans we ever got though. We was doing a Radio 1 show, the first show we ever done, and we was doing a Radio 1, and it was amazing because it was in the stage when. Ignore that. It was a stage when Peter.
Oh,
it was a stage when. I don't know if you've heard of Peter Andre.
Yeah.
Well, when Peter Andre was like at his peak, that's when we first started. They was all calling Peter's name, like, oh, Peter Andre, yeah, come in. We was like, oh, imagine if we ever got to that stage, and then they started calling our name, and it got bigger and bigger and bigger.
Crazy, huh?
And now it's
so
like,
then, yeah. Then you
boom,
made your first album, the boom.
Mm-hmm.
Then you made your first album. What was your input? Did you have anything to do with it? Cause
yeah. We wasn't even on the tracks. It was someone else.
Yeah.
No, but I mean, you know, you get put together, we'll get to the second later, but
that's why from the start we've always, like people keep saying to us, oh, you don't want to be classed as a boy band, and it isn't that at all, it's just that we say we feel we're a bit different from your average run-of-the-mill boy band, i.e. from the start, from the very first time we started recording tracks, their first album, we wrote some on the first album, we had input into all the stuff on the album, and that's the way it's been from the start, really.
All right. So where did you go with that album? Now, what do you remember going to?
The first one? Boy, I don't know. The first one was the whole sort of first album, it was all new, it was all scary. We didn't know what to expect. We didn't know what was around the corner, whether we'd be a success or whether we'd fail or anything like that. So we was all sort of like, well, what do we do now? And we had help from like certain individuals from the record company and close friends and all the rest of it that guided us along the way. And it's just, I mean, if we look back at it now, just sort of finished it off. And yeah. It's just done over 4 million albums worldwide. So to worry about this next album, like if we do the same as we did the first one, just let it go. Whatever happens is going to happen at the end of the day.
Yeah. Have you ever had a moment in time where you thought, whoa, I did not expect this. When I signed up to do the audition, this was not what I had in mind.
It doesn't happen that often, but when it does happen, it's normally when you've got a little bit of time off and you'll sit there and you'll start feeling... I know it sounds weird, but you'll start feeling a little normal again.
Mm-hmm.
And all of a sudden, when you realise the job you do and what you do, you sort of look back and you go...
I'll tell you what it is. I know, I find for myself, it's stuff like when we do get holidays, although they're never heard of, but if we have like 2 weeks off and we come back to England, then you get a magazine again, you're like, damn, completely forgot about this. And then like the first autograph comes when you're at the airport and you're like, oh no, starting again now, here we go.
That's you don't know how to translate at first.
Yeah,
do
you forget almost that you're that person.
Yeah.
I think on the flip side as well, there's also times where you think, I never expected this because it's like, at the time, it's so bad. You know, like when we first got in the band and we'd recorded the single and it was promo. We were working like 18-hour days and we were like, hang on a minute, this isn't what you know.
Yeah, yeah. It's
supposed to be all like, ha ha, you know, and it's like, yeah.
Mm. Yeah, I mean, as we've been through our really hard times, we're still going through our good times now, but you have to
let the good times roll.
You have to take the bad with the good, as everyone says. So there's good times, bad times, but
do you think you can keep up this pace? I mean, you're very young, you're very healthy, and you can do a whole lot of stuff. But
we're very young. I wouldn't say healthy. I'd say
Correct.
Young.
Not healthy anymore?
No. I think you can keep it up, but to be honest with you,
can you?
I couldn't.
Can you itch?
Yeah.
Lovely.
No, you. It's
healthy.
Basically, I couldn't do it forever. I couldn't do it for the rest of my life, what I do now, constantly. No.
So what do you, if you think about the future, what do you think? Quit at 40 or do something else?
I think maybe 55. I think we'll go for another 40 odd years.
I can be around when we're about 62.
Five are staying around, and they'll be around forever.
They're invincible, huh?
Yeah. We'll be these old wrinkly guys dancing around on stage.
Are you equally a good dancer? Because I was thinking about that too.
I'm by far just the best in the band. Yeah. Everything.
Yeah, I saw that.
We actually,
even on stage, innit? You just shine above us all.
I just have this certain aura about me.
That's why you're in the centre.
Before we actually go on stage, Jay stands in the middle, and the four of us get around, and we just.
Yeah, right. You're irreplaceable.
I've tried to be like Jay, and there's nothing I can do.
Well, we'll talk about that later. I can give you some tips, because I think I might help you. So now, second album. You wrote, you co-wrote, you did a whole lot of things on this album. Mm-hmm. Yeah, Tell me about that, please.
Well, we've written, basically, with producers, we've written every single song on the album,
I'm a little skeptic, because a whole lot of artists usually say, well, I co-wrote, and that then means that they maybe changed one or two tiny little words, and then they say, well, I co-wrote. Did you co-wrote like that, or did you actually truly write?
We've written all the lyrics and like all the melodies for the words, and we've got involved in some of the music, but some not as much, you know. But all the words and all the vocal melodies are totally from us.
When we say co-wrote, whereas a lot of bands that means, like you say, the producer wrote, say, a verse, and then one of the band members changed a word or something.
Exactly.
With us, it's the other way around. Yes. With our producers, with Richard Stannard in Ireland, who we did the full album with, it would be the total opposite way around. We'd write the full verse, and he'd say, what do you think about changing that line to that line? And we really, really did write the full thing ourselves.
Now, it's a very happy album, it's very positive, and it's
pop music, and everybody keeps saying to us, a lot of people ask us what the meaning is behind this and that, and maybe it does, a little bit of it does have meaning, but the whole idea is we're a pop band, it's supposed to be light, it's supposed to be fun, so that's what we tried to do with it.
That's what we're talking about.
This would be the album.
If you want to
zoom in on that.
The guy in the middle, he's
Can you just see how I shine above the rest?
Yeah.
It's something I've sort of been, it's kind of been almost a hindrance through my life, but I've learned to deal with it.
To be honest with you, you might not as well say five, it should say Jay, you know? And then, like, you know, we're just sort of in the background, so.
Yeah.
Really, it's Jay Invincible.
Actually, if you want, you could leave and I could just finish here with
you. Well, I'll just the same as well.
You can sit anywhere.
Lovely jump.
Now, so, how about the drinking song? Is that a drinking song?
A drinking song?
Yeah, it sounds like the drinking song, Mr. Z.
Mr. Z, no, that just is just our head.
It's not a drinking song?
No.
Then I have now decided it to be a drinking song.
Is that
song.
What it is?
It's not, no, it, to me, I heard it and I thought, oh.
Do you mind if I film you, Jay?
No, I'm used to, you know what I mean? Andy's, you know, it's no big thing for me. It's like everything, I just take it with a
in my stride. Do you mind if I screw this into your head?
No, go on.
I won't do it to you. I won't do it, you're too pressure.
Lads, you're forgetting that if he does the whole interview, it gets us out of work.
I'm willing to give you one more chance.
We're not willing to give you another chance.
If Jay's fine with it.
Let me show you something. I don't know if you can zoom in on this enough, but right in the centre there, right in the hole, you can see my face. You really can. Look, if you'd like to see. You can just see my face looking out.
Yeah,
it's all about Jay.
He's actually correct.
It is all about Jay. What can I say? The truth is out of the bag.
What can I say? Yeah, it's all about Jay.
Scott's just a resident nerd. Right, I employ Scott to be a nerd, you see, as he just proved himself.
So Scott, please tell me about your fascination with Star Wars.
I hate Star Wars.
Then why on earth do you add to a track all about Star Wars?
What?
Am I singing lead on that track? Tell me now.
On what song?
Battlestar.
No, that's Abs.
What?
A Battlestar Night like on Jedi. Something with the
You are on the track, right?
I like the song. Yeah. I think the song's very good, but
I don't like Star Wars. To be honest, I have to say, I've never given it a chance.
It's about Star Galactica. It's not Star Wars.
It's
about Star Wars, though, isn't it?
No.
If you feel the Force.
Yeah, kind of, but it's not like we didn't sit down and think, yeah, Star Wars.
Oh, Force was just...
Yeah, if you feel the Force of the power of us rocking you,
just
baby.
Words. It's just like words. Any sort of pop song, like we said at the beginning, it's not like a meaningful thing. Our lyrics aren't meaningful. You take them any way you want. You're taking them that way. Absolutely fine.
Star Wars.
Any way you want.
I call it Star Wars.
Fair enough. There you go. It's your Star Wars song.
Okay, well, thank you.
See, there we go. Let me just show you something inside. It says there, a massive slap on the back to our co-writers. And then it has our producer's name, so they're our co-writers. We're not their co-writers.
Right.
On the album.
All right, thank you.
Very nice.
Nice one. Nice one, Jay.
And there you go.
Now, one of your manager passed away?
He certainly did.
Yeah.
That must have been tough.
It certainly was.
And it still is.
Yeah.
But, you know, we've just... excuse me, Rich, I don't think the camera can see me.
Basically,
we've just gone number one in Britain. And that's what Bob always wanted. Yeah.
Congratulations, guys.
That's what Bob would always have wanted. So we've given him his number one. Hopefully we can give him a number one album as well. The album is dedicated to Bob. Not a song on the album dedicated... Our whole album is dedicated to Bob. There's not a song about him or anything like that.
Would that be the album Invincible?
Yes, the album Invincible.
Out on the 8th of November.
It hit us hard, but, you know, we're carrying on. So.
Yeah, okay. So what are your current plans? What are you going to do?
Current plans at the moment, I mean, obviously, like, not to plug again, but we've got a second album out, so that means a lot of work involved with that in promoting the album.
It does, Rich.
And then we got a little bit of a Christmas break when we get to Christmas. And then
is there going to be a Christmas single?
No.
This is
the closest we're going to release to Christmas with the new single.
And then after Christmas, we come back and we're going to be, we've got 2 months working on our tour.
But then we will have a single out.
Yeah.
Then.
Yeah,
and then we're going to have another single out.
And then we are just kicking off the tour in April.
Aren't we?
And where's that tour?
No, March even. Is it March or April?
Yeah.
When does the tour come here?
I think it's August.
April.
No, it comes here in April. April the 7th.
At Ahoy Stadium in Rotterdam in Holland. And then to all the other people watching, once we've done Europe, which will be like Italy, Spain, some Germany gigs, some stuff like that.
Copenhagen and Sweden,
do apologise. After that, we should be going to Australia and New Zealand.
Yep.
And after that, or maybe we'll go to South America first. Don't know.
Do you want to conquer the entire world? Do you want to?
We are in the process of doing so.
Yeah, because you kicked off Westlife number one this week.
Do
you want to be bigger than the Backstreet Boys and NSYNC? Do you want to go to the States? Of course, you've already had singles out in the States.
Basically, what's happening with the States at the moment is we went platinum over there. Congratulations. we had a first single out there, which was When the Lights Go Out, which was the first single over there. It was the second single in England, the second single over there. Basically, that was in the charts over there for like about 24 weeks at number 10, and then all of a sudden it went to number 9. We've had to leave off America at the moment because we had so many... commitments.
And we're neglecting kind of other places.
So we've concentrated on Europe and we've concentrated on England, and then we're going to go back to America. If they wanted us then, hopefully they'll want us now. If they don't...
All right, that's
what we can do.
What
country did you like best? Where'd you go? You thought, wow.
There's like a few, do you know what I mean? But... I suppose it is really, really mad.
Mad.
Have a good totally time in Argentina. Generally South America.
Yeah, no, it's crazy, it's really as well.
It's mental.
Because it's a Latin American...
Passion.
All right, so you've been in Five for a couple of years now. I must imagine you're all financially independent now.
Yeah.
How does that feel? I've got 5 Ferraris.
You got 5?
No, he's got 5. He hasn't got 5. He's got a Ferrari.
Bingo. How many more do you want?
3 more.
No, but I mean, you're in a special position. You're very young.
Yeah, of course.
You've made a whole lot of money.
Mm-hmm.
Do you ever lay in your bed at night thinking,
Tossing and turning.
No, sometimes you lay in your bed worrying and worrying and worrying about things, and sometimes you lay in bed and you think, hey, you know what, I've really achieved something here and I've made something of myself, you know.
Yeah.
And I'm like that all the time, to say the truth. I've never, and I don't ever think I'll become complacent with it.
No,
I every day that I'm doing, Scott, that's really annoying while we're talking. Every day that we're doing whatever, doing this interview, doing a photo shoot, I always sort of step out of it and I'm like, how lucky am I to be here doing this, what I'm doing.
Yeah. See, that's where I'm
all the time.
Because I lay in bed and I just think of Sean all the time.
Yeah.
Well, everybody can have like
their own dreams.
That's fine.
You don't know how much.
Now, is the price high? I mean, you being with Billy, I read the magazines. Even over here in the Netherlands, we see pictures of you. We heard she was booed at in a concert, and then you get negative publicity. But is that difficult? Do you regret that sometimes?
I don't regret it. At the end of the day, you could be anonymous for a day. Because. No, you know, it's at the end of the day, you know, there's no point in thinking like that because you can't change what I am and what she is, do you know what I mean? And we just wish it wasn't so much of an issue, really, because, you know, when I'm at work, I'm at work, when she's at work, and, you know, if we're with each other, then we're not these pop stars that are together, we're just...
Right, but for the two of you, you aren't, but for the rest of the country, for the rest of the world.
Yeah, I suppose so, but then, yeah, I don't know, really.
Can't be nothing you can do about that, is
there? Nothing you can do about it at the end of the day. Do you know what I mean? So, whatever they want to do, we don't care.
I love you, Billy Rich.
Thanks, I love you, Dad.
Thanks, man.
All right, so, what's the best thing about being five, or what's the absolute worst thing about being five?
This question, lads?
Yeah, go for abs.
Right.
Go ahead.
What I'd say is, I do apologise because my hair needs a bit of water, I've just realised, and it's a bit dry and a bit fluffy.
Hey, listen, abs, you've offended no one.
Thank you. Basically, right, to say there's bad things about stardom, should I say, rather than five, because, I mean, you say you're in this job, you've wanted this job since you was like, what?
Since I was four.
Since you've just been born, you'd always wanted to be famous and achieve this dream and this goal in life. And you get it. And to say that there's bad things such as, like, you don't get to see your family and you miss them and you're always tired and most of the time and you have to sign things all the time. Why would you want to be in the job then if that's the case? Do you know what I mean?
Yeah.
You take, it's like if you was working in a supermarket, yeah, there might be horrible hours.
True.
But you've got to do it. It's just like the same as us.
True.
We enjoy it and
true.
Bad and things and just come part of the job.
And it's hardly, no matter how tired you feel, everybody, whatever they're doing, can feel down and tired a little bit.
Exactly.
But at the end of the day, we have got a very, very, very nice life.
Right.
And you can never actually sit there.
It'd be wrong to complain.
Yeah, it would be wrong to complain about it all because...
Yeah.
No, we're travelling around the world.
Is there anything...
Still allowed to complain, like, you know what I mean?
of course, everybody.
I actually had a moment the other day. I was driving along and I was thinking, I've just bought a car and I was thinking, I want a different one. And then I thought to myself, I totally went back and I thought, hang on a minute, you know, I had nothing when I joined this band and now I've got a really nice car and I'm being a bit like, and I was like, no, you know, I really appreciate what I've got, you know, and how hard I've worked to achieve it. So. Woo!
Woo! Last one more.
Very American of us, clapping ourselves.
You've achieved so much in such a short period of time. Is there anything else that you think, because I read that you do a lot of writing and you might want to write for...
A little bit of this, a little bit of that.
These magazines, huh? All lies. You might want to write for other people. Is there anything that you think, wow, this is my next goal? Because this was one of your goals, being in a band, being successful, now you've...
To tell you the truth, everything changes and shifts from... Like, if you had have asked me, myself personally, if you had have asked me that question 6 months ago, I would have said, I was saying when I first got into the band and before, I want to write and produce for other people, I want my own recording studio. Now, I do definitely want to do that, but I also have other things I want to do now as well.
Like what?
Like, I've been starting to think maybe when things are over, I wouldn't mind getting into more the business side of this industry, maybe a bit of management, a bit of blah, blah, blah. Things change all the time. It's like you set yourself, you achieve a goal, and you're about to achieve one, you set another one, and that's how I work personally. I'll never achieve all my goals because I'm always setting something else.
Not only that, but just in case, because the others don't know, myself and Jay are going to open a shop that do little plastic animals.
Mm-hmm.
But
But we should keep that down for a while still. Now, you've almost done it all. How about a five movie? Five the movie.
Speaking of shops, and I haven't told you about this, and I'll tell the world, I am actually opening a bar in Birmingham. I'm actually doing it.
What kind of bar?
Just a bar, like...
Good luck, Rich.
Well, that's an exclusive.
Can I come in and DJ for you?
Yeah.
That's an exclusive, because that's the first we've heard of it.
You're going to serve Heineken?
Yeah, I would imagine so. I shall have it at Free House.
What about Stella?
Have a beer on. Don't like Belgian beer.
Stella.
A little bit.
All right, five movie?
As we said before,
we can give you a scene from it if you want.
Yeah, okay.
What happens is we move.
Jay's the main character, right?
No, of course I am, you know.
Yeah.
Come on, jump in there and we'll pretend we're in line. Just have a chat.
All right.
We're
in my place.
Oh,
we're
in your place. All right, shot Corey.
We're just chilling.
Oh, right, okay.
Yeah, so I said to him, I didn't really understand what he was talking about, and at the end of the day, when it came down to it, I just wasn't sure about what he was saying, so...
But it must have been difficult, though.
Oh, yeah, it was
very... So I can imagine, you know, being arguments always a bad thing, and then...
Yeah, it was just, you know what I mean, but...
You're going to be fine with it.
Things changed, yeah, so eventually I said to him, I can't...
Hey, Jay, how are you doing, amigos?
All right,
I'll get the door.
I'm fine.
Okay.
Would you get the door?
Yeah.
Come in.
What? You're not
going to
believe this.
Oh my gosh.
No, you're really not going to believe it. You've got to calm yourself. No, don't get hysteric, man.
No.
Don't get hysteric. Just calm down.
I can't hold it back.
Okay?
I am really getting hysterical.
Yes. You know the new album?
Yes. Yeah.
They've only made one copy for one shop.
Oh no.
Dun, dun, dun. Only one person can buy the album.
Next week.
Anyway, back to the show. what are we going to do?
I don't know. What shall we do?
Shall I call the record company?
And freeze.
Find out what happens next week on the 5 series.
There
you
go.
So as you can see, we're really talented actors.
You see how talented we are.
You can clap for yourselves.
There's nothing cardboard about that.
Let me go back to my turn. Did you see the depth in those characters.
They really go far, don't they?
Did it churn your emotions?
Definitely. Yeah. Yeah.
Especially
definitely.
Sort of the scene.
I think it needs romance, though.
Yeah, there's another scene we can show you.
Oh, yeah, there is romance, but it's kind of...
No, I've done it now.
Actually, maybe you could be... You know, have a thing going and then you're being jealous.
You know what? You two make a really sweet couple.
Yeah.
I've never seen that before.
Yeah, I think that would do.
Yeah. And look, the red and grey.
Yeah, that's it. Oh. Actually, you could be
not
the
only one for me, mate.
Yeah.
Yeah.
The grey and the red.
Yeah.
But you do the trio. Yes. Great.
Richie? Shoney's the only one for me, baby.
Anyway,
thank you very much for your time, for your acting class.
Thank all of you for watching, I'd like to say.
It's been absolutely marvellous.
Well, thank you.
You know what? I want to take this opportunity, Scott.
Yeah, I've gone.
No, fine.
No, but you take this opportunity.
Do you remember what I've told you?
You just leave
it.
Yeah.
Remember what
I've
told
you? You leave that there.
Yeah.
Right, cool.
Abs.
Basically, what I was going
to
say was...
Take this opportunity to tell them.
I'd like to say...
Take this opportunity.
This one right now.
Yeah, take it.
I'm going to take this.
Well, you've missed it.
Seize the moment.
No, you've missed it. You said I'm going to take this opportunity and that's gone. You've missed it.
Take a new one.
Take a new one.
This one. This one.
I'd like to thank everyone out there that supported us, that's bought the CDs, that's bought the albums, that's turned up at the stage shows we've done, all the performance, the concerts, the Pepsi Pops and blah, 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 that's watched the TV programs, that's taped them, that showed them to their friends, that have made them want to be Five fans. Thank you very much for all your support. Without you, we wouldn't be who we are now. We wouldn't be where we are in the world. So
we love you.
Damn right. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
For feeding
Thanks very much.
Thank you.